start sort of the middle of the CTS race, just coming off the Musgrove Trail
at Whatcombe. We've in theory come from Sheldon, so this will be the stretch where it's gone from Sheldon. We've lost the 23 milers, so they would have gone one way.
Yeah.
And we're going this way and attacking the Musgrove Trail for the first time.
This is what you'll see. Not very interesting, I'm afraid. But it's got to be some road to it. I'm tired already. We've just left the car park about 1 minute ago.
She said those magic three words to me yesterday.
Yeah.
Yeah. Can't keep up.
Oh, right.
Never said those to me before. Unbelievable.
So do I leave that bit in?
Oh, yeah.
Steve said he can't keep up.
Oh, yeah.
And there's a road. Pause. Alpaca thing, whatever that is.
There's about 35, isn't there, something like that?
Turn right up here.
Turn right here. Doggies. So turn here. Musgrove Trail. Oh, you fitted through there, Steve, well done. Nice. And then up. Alright. It starts bouncing up and down. Past the Brunel Wood. Some mighty fine erections in the woods. Am I out of breath?
I don't know.
And we've gone approximately half a mile. Oh, getting hot now. 6 o'clock in the morning, we've already been running for 100 miles and we thought we'd just recce out the last 20 of city to sea. Okay, so we turn up here, apparently, according to our guru. Steve, I can run 100 miles in 13 hours, Hookins. Come on then, oh, he's running, there you go, look, crumbs. The views. Oh, they're running, they're going! Oh no, 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 no! Steve's lost, even with a map. So, we're not going to be running this bit, alright? So make sure you're not down this bit. You've gone the wrong way. Leave it up to Steve. The Linney, a little bit of a detour and we got lost, but now it's the Linney. No, we did get here in the end. Steve's added an extra 3 miles on, I think. Yeah, past the Linney.
A long Willow Park Lane.
Willow Park Lane. Yeah, ah. I have to ask this gentleman. Up the deep, dark wood.
It's heading the direction we want, isn't it?
Yeah.
It could well be that we're on the way.
Yeah. So, it's either here or in that field next to us.
Yeah.
So it's one of the two.
Yeah.
So you end up down the slope.
Yeah.
Down the road. What mileage is this then, Steve, do you think? So is the checkpoint in here? And actually in the slope?
No, not in the slope.
No?
No, just down here.
Yeah.
Cheers.
So we come across this road here?
Yeah.
Ah. Slope.
Yeah, we come down over here.
This is School Road. Checkpoint's down there. It could be in there.
Yeah, next to the
there you go, Mark.
But running, we go this way. Or walking, or crawling, or dying.
Yeah, come around this way. This should be Summit Hill.
Oh, yeah. This is the way you come over, across the bridge?
Yeah, that's it.
Yeah.
Don't even turn left. Did you want to sort out your bag?
No, no, fine. Road. Very nice, but there you go, what can you do? How are you finding it so far, Debbie? You finding it fun? Hello, wave, wave to the kids, say hello to the kids. Hello. How are you finding it, Steve?
Easy with the map.
Yeah? Easy, so we haven't got lost once then?
No.
Ah, right, there you go. Look at him. Like Indiana Jones. Going under Hamlin Way. Beep, beep. Eating a Mars bar. Sort of thing you should have with a nice cup of tea while you're watching a film. As a treat. Not just stuffing it down your neck. Because you need calories. That's the life of an ultra runner. That's why I'm so fat. Because I'll still eat one tonight when I'm having a cup of tea watching the telly. But there you go. Steve doesn't. Steve's very good with his food. Steve, which way?
Up this way and then on the left.
On the left? You sure it's not on the right?
Which way are you going?
Yeah.
For us, it's on our left.
It's on our left. Up Bench Tor Close?
Next one up.
Next one?
Yeah. See, we could have stayed on this lane, not come out.
There. Right. So we turn left at Fernworthy Close, but on the day it could be a tweak, it could be the one behind us or the other one, but it'll take you the same way. Okay.
on. Right, we've now basically followed this down to Cockington now.
Follow this down to Cockington. Oh, windy, blimey. It's very windy. Oh. This way, that way? Oh, I don't know. No.
Well, I think any of the ways we go now is going to get us down to Cockington, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah, go this way.
I'd say this seems a bit more.
Yeah. Well, you go front.
Wave, Debbie. Last one there buys the beers. Lots of greenery. If it's not raining, this will be fine without off-roaders on. None of us have got off-roaders on. The only bit that's a bit dodgy is between Timoth and Whatcombe. Could be quite slippery there. Off-road. Off-roaders are quite comfy. Well then. Now. Nice lane down here now, so you carry on down this one all the way to Torquay Seafront and then on the way to Preston. Okay. Well, Steve found it really easy and is looking forward to coming first. He's looking at doing it in about 7.5 hours. Myself and Debbie will be looking at hopefully just getting it under the cutoff time. But Steve will certainly be pushing it for the 7.5 hours. So he is hoping to have 2 portions of fish and chips at the end, if he's allowed. All right, so that'll be it, because we're going to turn left in a minute and go back up to Whatcombe for the car. And I'll maybe make one more video for the part from Paignton to Berry Head and back, if I get chance. Okay. One last bit then. It was going to be the end a minute ago, but we decided we'll run to the end here. Under this bridge. Yeah, under this bridge. And then basically, this will probably be about mile 30, and from the Whatcombe part where we started, it's nearly 11, just under. Okay. That's Berry Head over there. We turn right, carry all the way onto Paignton. All the way into Paignton, Preston, Paignton, Brixham, Berry Head. Okay, and there's Debbie and Steve. And that's what it was from the Whatcombe. Okay, so you run right to the end of that Berry Head and don't run off the end because you can. All right, bye.
Yeah, to Berry Head.
Another point.
Back.
On the way back from Brixham, you'll actually run this way, up probably the other side of the road, along the seafront, which we'll probably run now, won't we?
Yeah.
I think we will, won't we?
Yeah, we've got to get back to Whatcombe out of the car.
And around that way, I'll probably take one more bit of film as we're going along the seafront by the wheel. Yeah, so we're going to go left here, so the finish will be around down to the wheel, carry on through the wheel, right up to the Imperial Hotel, coast path around to Babbicombe. I'm not exactly sure of the distance, but it's probably about 5 miles.
Yeah.
About 5 miles from here. Okay. Easy peasy miles. Right. Bye.